The committee is scrutinizing the report of the Auditor General on financial statements of NADS for the financial year 2021-2022. Chichoncho was expected to appear before the committee but delegated his colleague Asimwe Mugumia, who was rejected by the committee.
I spoke to the person who was invited and he said he would be here. Otherwise, this morning he called and said he was sending someone from the law firm. Just a few minutes ago, so I hope he should be here in a minute or so.
No.
The person who has been sent was actually.
Let's first wait for that person. He has just confirmed to us right now that he's one of the what associates, not so. And duly qualified also to go to that courtroom. So why didn't you go and for him he comes here?
I think that question would be better posed to Mr. Chichoncho.
Okay.
Guess it's before which magistrate?
He's called Ronald. I forget the other name.
Which magistrate? Where is it? Where is the case?
According to the Auditor General's report, NADS advanced 39 billion shillings to Pathways Advocates to compensate tea nursery operators who had sued the government for failure to procure their seedlings, but a number of farmers were not paid.
How much have you paid to date? And how much is outstanding? Then three, what was the total amount?
It should come to the attention of this committee that these farmers were NADS farmers, not the lawyers' farmers. And NADS has been dealing with them for a very long time, ever since they started, especially in Kigezi. They have been with them for a very long time. Here they might have gone to court. Because
in a later preview to the committee dated 9th September 2021 to NADS, Patrick Katabazi claimed to have paid full amounts to all farmers as awarded by court in the consent judgment of 2019. But the committee has evidence that farmers only received 70% of the money, while others claim they received nothing.
When he was demanding the money, 27 billion, who are those that were supposed to receive the money? And how much each of them? And how far have you gone to manage the consent? Because under paragraph 5, you are supposed to have verified, carried out a joint verification of the claim. Have you done that?
I'm wondering why nothing has...
The evidence of receipt of 27 and 12 billion.
Yes, there's no signature.
In the system, they may not show signature.
No, but
it must
when
be
it's
proof.
Printed, you yes. See, the way the thing
acknowledgement,
is...
Acknowledgement, yes.
The way it is written here is signature, vote controller. Okay? Then signature, accounting officer.
But the EFT, which is printed on the system also, is a very, very good confirmation that money has been sent and has arrived on the account of the beneficiary. If you see the page before, there is an EFT electronic transfer form, which is issued by Bank of Uganda, I think Ministry of Finance. So that is the final evidence that money has been paid into the account of the beneficiary.
This prompted the committee's vice chairperson, Lucy Akello, to summon Chichoncho to appear before the committee on Tuesday without fail and furnish the committee with details.
The money which went out, did it really achieve the purpose? Something of that sort.
Meanwhile, the same committee has been shocked by the expenditure of 3.4 billion shillings by NADS on travels inland as per the audit query of the same financial year.
Tough, because now when you talk of allowance, it's also being mentioned here under, you know, inland trip. Then when you talk about fuel is also being mentioned here, but you have a separate, you know, budget for fuel, something of that sort.
The audit also revealed that NADS spent 408 million shillings on allowances, 332 million shillings on fuel, 441 million shillings on maintenance of vehicles. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.